The greatest thing about human life is the ability to manage your mind. I had the unique privilege of watching one of the giants of science demonstrating his control over mind. It's a very rare instance. I was a very young child and I used to go to All India Radio Dharwad for children programs. Dr. H.K. Ranganath was a producer of All India Radio, with a celebrated theatre personality. We finished our recording and we were coming out. At that time we saw Dr. H.K. Ranganath coming with Sir C.V. Raman. To see Sir C.V. Raman was a great thing for us. And you can visualize the same turban, close collar coat, with his hands tied behind him. He is walking very seriously along with Dr. Ranganath. And Dr. Ranganath somehow gathered courage to ask Dr. Sir C.V. Raman, "Sir, can we give a talk on radio?" Raman did not say no. He said, "What time?" Ranganath looked at the watch, it was about 7:20. He said, "Sir, between 7:50 and 8, I have 10 minutes slot. Can you give a lecture, sir?" Raman did not say no. "What topic?" he asked. "How can Ranganath give topic to Sir C.V. Raman?" Raman smiled and said, okay, I'll speak about the color of flowers." Immediately the announcement was made on the radio that there will be a live broadcast of Professor C.V. Raman's lecture on color of flowers. Those days, radio was the only mode of entertainment and knowledge. We didn't have the television at that time. And I am sure lakhs of audience would be glued to the radio to listen to the words of Sir C.V. Raman. And then Ranganath took Sir C.V. Raman to the recording studio. As you can visualize, there was a studio and a round table there. Raman was ushered in. He was made to sit at the edge of the table. Mic was kept before him and Ranganath very politely told him, "Sir, I will be in the recording room, next room. There is a glass partition between the studio and the next room. I will be there, sir." And exactly at 8:50, sorry, I should correct it, exactly at 7:50, a red light will flash and I will gesture from the other room, sir, gesture like this, "You can start talking, sir." And again he folded his hand and said, "Sir, please remember it is only for 10 minutes, sir. Because at 8 o'clock the national news comes, I have no control over that." Raman smiled and said, okay, 10 minutes, right. And something he did extraordinary. He removed his the turban that he had on top, kept it on the table. It was a completely bald plate with a small little juttu on the back side. Raman again said, "10 minutes, Ranganath?" "Yes." He rubbed his hand. Top, he hammered his juttu and said, ten minutes. Then Ranganath came to the other side, recording studio. The door of the studio was closed and Raman was watching Ranganath. Exactly at 7:50, red light flashed and Ranganath made a gesture like this. Raman started speaking. "My dear listener," he said and closed his eyes. Then he went on talking so beautifully. Why the flowers are colored, what constitutes the color of the flower, how do you define color. I tell you, he was speaking as if he is talking to school children. Anybody would understand, and even the scientists would be mesmerized by the way he analyzed these matters so simply. Words would flow out of his mouth. Many people struggle hard to read the prepared speech, but he had no prepared speech. He was just closing his eyes and talking fluently. 3 minutes went by, 4 minutes, 5 minutes, 6 minutes. Ranganath was there and we were gathered around this recording studio. Ranganath said, "You're very fortunate, huh? You have the chance of listening to the Nobel laureate." He said, "Yes, sir." 6 minutes, 7 minutes over. Then slowly Ranganath started becoming tense. He was looking at Raman. Raman was not opening his eyes at all. He was talking continuously. Ranganath was worried. If he had opened his eyes, at least to make a gesture, "Sir, time is up, some signal can be given to him." This man is not opening the eyes at all. He is talking continuously. 8 minutes went, 8.5 minutes. Now Ranganath started sweating in the air-conditioned room. He started pacing up and down. He was asking his assistant, I think you'll close, no? How can the assistant be sure? He said, hope so, sir. 9 minutes over and still Raman is not opening his eyes. Ranganath went up to the recording studio door. He was tempted to open the door, but the problem in live broadcast, it's not a recorded broadcast, is if he opens the door when the recording is going on, you get a sound on the radio. So it doesn't matter if the sound comes also, it's okay. If he goes and touches Raman, suddenly you would wake up and say, what happened? You can't do that. It is a live broadcast. Ranganath was in terrible predicament whether to go inside the room or not to go inside the room. Finally, 9 minutes and 20 seconds over, he decided, come what may, I should go inside. His major worry was, if Dr. Raman does not open his eyes, then stop before 8 o'clock. The national news will intercept everything and come. And people in that area would next day take Ranganath to task, which is more important, national news or Sir Savi Raman's talk? National news you hear every day. Do you hear Raman's talk every day? They'll be angry. But what can poor Ranganath do? 9 minute 35 seconds. I think he must have almost his heart stopped. He came to the door and he was about to push and go inside. It was 9 minute 40 seconds. Raman said, that's all my dear listener. Thank you so much. Ranganath ran back to the recording studio and told his assistant, now closing, connect it to the national hookup, let the national news come. And again he went back into the recording studio. Raman was sitting there. Ranganath went and held his feet, touched his feet. Raman said, what are you doing, Ranganath? What are you doing? Ranganath said, sir, you almost killed me, sir. Why? Sir, you are not opening your eyes. And you are continuously talking. If it had gone another 15 seconds more, I was in a serious difficult situation, sir. Because the national news would come and your talk will be incomplete. How will our people take it, sir? Raman looked puzzled and asked him, Ranganath, you have told me 10 minutes, no? Yeah, but you are not opening your eyes, sir. So why should I open my eyes? You told me 10 minutes. I had told my computer 10 minutes. And it would stop before 10 minutes. Look at this ability of this man. Many people with a clock in front of them cannot see the time and do the job on time. But here was a man who was closing his eyes and the mental clock was continuously working and reminded him exactly 15 seconds before the 10 minute time was over. This is the ability of a man to manage his mind. Why people achieve enormous success in life is they know how to control and manage their mind. All minds are equally good. Some minds are trained to be effective. Some minds are not trained to be effective. If the mind is not trained, it can create havoc. If the mind is disciplined, it can cause anything. It's like a light source. When you put the torch on and keep it in the dark light outside, in the dark sky, you can see a cone formed. A cone of light is formed. The light scatters. Starts from the origin, goes on scattering elsewhere. But what happens in case of a laser? All the lights are focused. Battery light cannot be seen beyond a particular point. Say 30, 40, 50 feet, you can't see the torch. But the laser can cut a 1-inch thick iron sheet. Both are light only. The light focused has tremendous power. Light focused loses its power. Same thing is true with our human mind. When the mind is focused, it can achieve amazing things like the one demonstrated by Sir C.V. Raman. What I saw in the childhood still haunts me. And I think that is the reason for some outstanding people to have achieved greatest heights in their lives. Let us try to manage our mind also in a small, effective way.